Hey there, it's Montina Portisera. We are in the studio. Now, our guest today, this is just, I can't tell you. I got the business card and thought, oh my goodness. So let me tell you a little bit about Mr. Phil Parker. He's a successful businessman, author, mentor, and former CEO. Phil is a 35-year veteran of corporate America. So Phil, we're not here to talk about corporate America and business. We're here to talk a little bit about the ABCs. Why don't you give the listeners a little bit about your background?
Well, before I wrote the book, I was, as you said, a member of corporate America. And when I left the corporate world, I didn't know what to do with the rest of my life. And so in consultation with my lovely wife, Bonnie, I decided to write several books. The ABCs of Senior Sex was the third one that I've written.
Oh, wow. Okay, so he mentioned it there, the ABCs of Senior Sex. So what other books have you written?
Well, my first book was called Kiss Yourself Hello, From a Life of Business to the Business of Life. And it was my transition from the corporate CEO to what do I do now? Which I think many executives today face as they leave the corporate, when they lose their title, their sense of being, well-being. Second book was called The Gift of Perspective. Let My Hindsight Be Your Foresight. Don't make the same mistakes I made. I've already been there, done that. And then, of course, the third book, Grandpa Does Grandma, The ABCs of Senior Sex, was written because of a question a young woman asked me at the Barnes, my local bookstore. Mm-hmm. Having a cup of coffee one day, she said to me, how old are you? I said, I think I was 75 at the time. Mm-hmm. She said, 75? She says, well, now that you don't have sex anymore, what do you do? What do you do for excitement?
Wow, and that's pretty bold.
Yeah, that kind of threw me. And I came home and told my wife about it. And she said, what are you going to do about that? I said, I'm going to write a book about
it. I wrote the book on it. So what makes you an expert on the subject? I'm almost afraid to ask that.
Well, I don't know that anyone ever gets to be a total expert on the subject of sex and intimacy. But after 77 years of practicing, I'm starting to learn the ropes. And thanks to my lovely wife, Bonnie, and our communications and our trust in one another, our intimacy and sexuality is going on and on and on, which just really dispels the myth that as you get older, intimacy and sexuality kind of goes off into the sunset.
I love that. And his lovely wife is here, as you'll see here on the segment. Now, let me tell you, did you write the book only from the man's point of view?
Well, originally, I wrote it from the man's point of view. And then when Bonnie looked at it, she said, that's a little bit raw.
Oh.
I said, well, you know, men are a little bit edgy. So she decided to write the second half of each chapter, which is called On the Softer Side.
I like that.
And it's written from a woman's point of view. In other words, men are, you know, bip, bam, thank you, ma'am kind of thing. And women are more communicative,
yes,
listening, want to be nurtured, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so my wife is responsible for that part of the book.
So we have the softer side. Now, what will women viewers and readers take away after reading your book?
Well, hopefully they'll begin to understand that just because they age and they get older, that doesn't mean that their relationship in terms of intimacy, sexuality, should go away. Sex really has no time limit and also has no age limit. So the myth that as we get older and as we age, and we have an aging population, as you well know,
mm-hmm,
and the myth is that, oh, we're 55, 65, 75, 85, what do we do now? Because we're not sexual, we're not intimate, we don't maintain our relationships, which nothing could be further from the truth, at least in my experience. And of course, I think it takes a nurturing partner.
I can tell you right now, as we're wrapping it up in the studio, I want to be part of this senior sex movement as I grow older with my husband. But I tell you, when we say senior, I mean, what are we really talking now? Is it about 60, 65? At what age should someone pick up this book as we wrap up in the next 30 seconds?
Well, originally I thought it was for the senior community. Mm-hmm. Turns out as people hit the website, grandpadoesgrandma.com, we're finding that the 40, 45-year-old, 50-year are learning some new things as well. So it's really a book for everything. Sure, and you can see me on the side if you want to learn.
All right, Phil, thanks for being a guest in the studio today. All of his information is right here where you can actually get a copy of this book so that you can learn a few things. And look, here, I'm in my 40s. Well, heading into 40, and I tell you what, I'm going to pick it up too. Don't tell my husband. All right, thanks, Barry. Thanks, Phil, for joining us.
Thank you, Montana, for having me. It was a real pleasure.
Yes. All right, so as we're actually wrapping up here, if you'd like to be a guest in the studio, all of our information's right here below. But I'm going to do something a little different with this segment, so make sure that you tune in tomorrow.